in Boston, where just moments ago, the amazing career of Shannon Miller hit the crossroad, her very first vault. As she came here to Boston to compete in the Olympic trials, she did so on a bad right leg.
We're gonna get her into the back room. Hold on, we're just gonna get her to stand up first.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Okay.
This is gutsy stuff. Is it the same stress fracture in the knee, or is it something different?
One thing's for sure, if it can be done, Shannon's the one that'll do it.
You want to take a third run down? Just
husband
a run
Chris
down,
Phillips.
Please.
Just run on the way back.
Huh? Let's just run on the way back, all right?
What are her options here, guys?
Well, actually, what she can do, believe it or not, she has the option of running down the vault.
Huh? Well, here's what you got to do. If you're going to run down there and it feels awkward, you run by the horse. You got three runs. You got it?
Yeah.
So you run down there, you run by the horse. If it's not fast enough, if it feels good, you go ahead and do it. If not, you're out of the meet. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay, this is the difference. So you run by the horse or you pop it up there and go. There's no halfway.
Yeah.
You got it? Okay.
She actually can run by the horse. She has that option, can walk right back, do it again, no deduction. Sounded like that's what Steve was saying first off, and then he decided maybe that's just too risky.
She had no U.S. nationals. These Olympic trials, these 2 days, the toughest gymnastics test that she's had in 3 years were to determine her Olympic dream.
And Steve Nuno complained to me before the meet began, said she's the only one here who's got to go through 3 meets. She had to be verified just to be in the meet before this one even got going. Was very frustrated with that.
She survived it. But now, a limp, a very noticeable limp.
Yeah. Hold on, hold on, hold on to my shoulder. Okay, good try. All right.
Okay. In the world, but those arms up again.
It was the weirdest thing. You just pulled it down. Okay. Right.
The exact thing.
I want to go into the training room.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I want to turn and go to the training room. All right. All right, let's just, let's do that, okay? All right, here we go.
So, Shannon Miller went to the training room here at the Fleet Center in Boston. What news comes out is still to come as an amazing night gets started. This is it. The tumbling that started then has brought Vanessa Attler to the trials of her Olympics now. For 3 years, there has been no doubt that she would be going.
It's my
own God.
Oh my God.
Now there is doubt. Just a few months ago, Jamie Danchard started performing like she never has. She's kept it going, and it's a precious hope for three. Alyssa Beckerman has learned how pressure can lead to a body's betrayal. And her dream is precarious at best. Is it how you start or how you finish? After a rough beginning, Morgan White came back trying to force the ladder. Dominique Dawes goes back to Olympics. Her question is, did she come back to the quest for three too late? And then there's the woman who's worn more medals than any other. Shannon Miller wants the chance to be magnificent again. trials. This is the man. These are their dreams. This is it. You want Survivor? We've got Survivor. Live we are at an SRO Fleet Center in the hub of New England, Boston, Massachusetts. Already a very eventful first rotation. Let's show you what happened to Vanessa Atler from Plano, Texas, where she now trains on an apparatus that has driven her a little crazy in her career.
And unfortunately, we've seen these errors from Vanessa time and time again, and I have to tell you, it absolutely drives
right
Bella
there, supposed to go past
crazy.
The handstand. We saw a flicker of fear in Vanessa right from the get-go. She's leaping over the bar. Simple element, legs come apart, concentration. You can tell the way she works through this exercise that she's just wanting to get off of the bars. That's not the way you're supposed to do it.
And a bounce at the end. Tim, show us where she got in trouble right from the beginning.
So right from the start, you see those legs come apart right there. That's just a flicker of fear, panic. She's not concentrating.
And you usually know with Vanessa that it's not going to be a great exercise right from the beginning. Here she was supposed to go over the bar, obviously covering up something she's had to do many times before.
Because of these errors, especially the one where she didn't go over the bar, her start score's lowered to a 9.6, and it produces a look like this, and that does not help Vanessa Atler's cause at all.
Well, the pressure really goes up now on Vanessa Atler to stick her next three events, and she will be coming up next. We want to go back and listen to Steve Nuno, the coach of Shannon White, right after they emerge from the training room. They're making a critical decision.
I think it's safe to risk. If you are going to be considered, you have to be considered healthy, okay? So I don't want to do any further. If there's any stiffness or, you know, if you're not going to do a really good job, then it's not worth it to us, okay? So this is what we're going to do. We're going to scratch the rest of this meat, let our results stand for what they are, okay? Obviously, you missed the same ball, unfortunately, but, you know, you warmed it up fine. And you warmed it up with an exceptional, you know, power. So you're okay with that. You and I are okay with that. All right. Now, what's going to happen? We have to let everything else stand. You understand? Okay. And now I don't want to be a further distraction to the rest of the group. So I want you just to be there and be supportive of the rest of the team. Okay. We're not going to feel sorry for ourselves. We trained hard for this meet. You're in this meet. And you're going to treat everybody else and the rest of the meet like you would be in the meet. Got it?
Now the selection procedures.
Shannon Miller dealing with withdrawing from the Olympic trials. And this could be how her highly rewarded gymnastics career comes to an end. Now back live for Vanessa Atler, Al Troutwick, Tim Daggett, Elfie Schlegel. The first vault for Vanessa Atler. That miss on the uneven bars, as we mentioned, that ups everything that's, you know, left for her tonight.
Now, Bella said to us this morning he just wishes he could find that button to give her the fire.
Well, it's a great vault. There's no doubt about it. Vanessa Atler can vault, and that really helps her cause dramatically. This team, just about any scenario you put together, they come up a little bit shy, especially on vaulting and a little bit on floor, and Vanessa Atler fills that bill. She plugs that hole.
Okay, you heard Steve Nuno and Shannon Miller. She wanted to know about whether they can apply to go further into the training camp or be an alternate or whatever. What are their options?
Well, the selection procedures are very open-ended. It's not spelled out. Bella Caroli told me yesterday, no question about it, sorry to say this, he said he will not take an injured athlete. It's not fair. It puts too much pressure on the other athletes. He won't do it.
Well, let's recap what's going on here. This is the second and final night of the Olympic trials, the fourth step in selecting the Olympic team. Tonight, while we are here in Boston live, at the conclusion, Bella Caroli and three other members of a selection committee will go into a room and announce in front of the sellout crowd the six members of the Olympic team and then two alternates, not ranked in any form.
This ball's different. Handspring laid out front with a half turn.
Oh my God.
And that
could
be disastrous. for this young lady, because she doesn't make this team by bars. She doesn't make it by beam. She makes it because she can jump, she can vault, and she can tumble. This vault's supposed to be a handspring laid out front, and this is, once again, this is just second-guessing herself. She gets a little bit cautious, starts balking, doesn't go for it, tucks her knees. It's a totally different vault, much lower start value.
Bella Caroli deciding, choosing, not liking.
Yeah, he knows she cannot deal with the pressure.
Yeah, I mean, this is such a bad sign for him, because he knows, like Elfie just mentioned, that pressure is a big factor. And if she's feeling it here, what's going to happen in the medal round in Sydney?
The uneven bars, which were waiting for Shannon Miller. She will not arrive. Her Olympic trials are done. So much has already happened. Boston has been an amazing host city for the U.S. Olympic trials. Huge crowds for the men and the women tonight as we welcome you back live to our coverage. And we will know who will represent the United States of America in Sydney, Australia at the Olympic Games. And so far, the biggest door of opportunity in this sport has opened wide. The retirement from competition tonight of Shannon Miller, the two missed routines of Vanessa Adler. Morgan White has nailed her one routine on the uneven bars at 9.612. Vanessa Adler gets a shade over a 9.1 on the vault. So here we are. Elise Ray and Krista Maloney, they've been outstanding and 1-2 since we started weeks ago in St. Louis. Amy Chow has continued to make a major statement in these trials. She's looking solid. Jamie Dancher, also very, very consistent. Morgan White came here to Boston in seventh place. She's moved up to fifth. Vanessa Adler is precariously holding on to a spot behind the very smooth Dominique Dawes, who had a good beginning on vault. Now, Morgan White, coached by Mary Lee Tracy, is liked by Bella Caroli. She has the look of a gymnast. And Bella has been aghast at what he has seen from Vanessa Adler. Now, he is talking to Tracy Talavera. Shari Knight Hunter and Marilyn Cross are the other members of the selection committee, and the campaigning is beginning.
I'll tell you why he likes Morgan White. He loves her because he calls her his sturdy one, the consistent one. He's looking to this young lady to be the lead-off athlete at the Olympic Games. Start with a high score. Set the tone.
Now, in this second half of the second rotation, there is another young woman who is eligible in this Olympic year because she was born prematurely by 6 weeks. Tasha Schweikert from Las Vegas, Nevada, who was inserted as a last-minute emergency replacement back in February in Las Vegas and seized it. She was so impressive, she was asked back to two other events under the auspices of USA Gymnastics, and Bella Caroli liked her as well. If suddenly Vanessa Adler is so shaky, Tasha Schweikert, who didn't seem to be in the mix when we came on the air tonight, just after 16 minutes of us bringing you coverage of this event, is in the mix again, and so is Alyssa Beckerman. Your take on things.
Got a lot happening. A lot happening. No doubt about that. As you mentioned, Tasha Schweikert, she is in the running. She's been one that Bella has looked to. He likes her style. He likes her look with gymnastics, long, clean lines. Alyssa Beckerman, as you mentioned, had a rough day the first day. Much better today.
Now, Vanessa Adler had gone backstage here at the Fleet Center to sort of gather herself. She has two more rotations to go. That's Valerie Liukin, who has worked Vanessa extra hard yesterday and today, pushing her to get over some of these things that stand in her way.
Yeah, the biggest problem is obviously not physical. I saw Vanessa Adler do that vault so many times this week. It was purely just a mental error, and that is what's going to hurt her more than the score she got. Wow.
Why the wow?
Mary Lee Tracy told me four times. She lands on her feet four times on four different routines today. She is going, no doubt about it. Couldn't agree with her more. That's the best opening vault I've seen White do so far. Beautiful position, an improvement on the landing. She struggled in St. Louis at the Nationals on vaulting. Here looks much better. Beautiful body position. Just the step on the landing. But watch the height and look at the straight body. You got to have guts to go for it this way because you can sit that down so easily like we saw Shandon Miller do.
Bella Caroli, all business tonight and very emotional in reacting to what he sees. It is going to be Bella's team. I mean, yes, there is a committee and there will be conversation and there will be negotiating, but...
And that's been going on, and it's going on right now as we speak. Every routine, they're looking at it, they're going, well, that kind of hurt this person, that kind of helped. What does that do?
Well, and Bella also mentioned, speaking with Mary Lee Tracy, she said he's very intuitive, and he knows the right chemistry for this team.
9.062 on the low side. Why?
Well, actually, it has a low start value. They really are very, very strict with Morgan. She's not a big person, so she looks a little bit smaller.
But sometimes this is a big-time vault for her. That's a new one.
Very good. You know, just a small little thing on the landing, but that's going to be an improvement, certainly over the first score. I'm telling you, she's got nothing to worry about. This girl's going to Sydney. If she makes two more routines, no problem.
But, Tim, there is one thing that every gymnast has to keep on their mind, especially after seeing Shandon Miller on the vault. You've got to stay healthy here in the rotations that are left.
And that's something that she's got going for her. She's a little bit younger. You know, Shandon Miller, Dominique Dawes, they're proving you can do this sport at an older age. But when you're young and like that, you get a reaction like that from Bella Caroli, and that speaks volumes.
Elise Ray, the reigning national champion. She ended the two-year run of Kristen Maloney, but they did so with great respect. They're going to be good teammates together.
You know, it's hard to believe that last year after the national championships, Kelly Hill was saying that, you know, she really questioned how far she could take Elise Ray. She never believed in herself, and it wasn't until that championship that Elise finally believed how good she could really be, and she's great here.
It's going to help her in Bella's eyes. Kelly Hill's obviously ecstatic, but she is challenging some of the world's best on bars. She's a contender to win a medal in the Olympic Games on this event.
You know, I said it before, Elise Ray just has beauty. It's graceful. She makes everything look so beautiful. Look at the lines. She's going for the perfect landing. She knows she's a contender in Sydney.
Morgan White gets a 9.193 on average after a second vault that scored better than the first.
That's the best she's done so far.
All right, our first look tonight at Tasha Schweikert. We watched her warming up on the vault. Now, she is ninth after the first rotation. Now, people might say, wait a minute, there are only six spots. How suddenly is she in the mix and on the bubble?
You gotta fill in the pieces. That's what's most critical. Everybody's not good on every event. Everybody doesn't have to do every event.
That's one of the pieces.
Now you see that vault. She actually maybe took a slightly bigger step than Morgan White. Maybe didn't have as good of a body position, but she flies a little bit higher, goes a little bit longer, and that should help in her score.
Not to mention that the start value on this vault is a 9.8.
Which means that if she hit it perfectly, that is the highest score she could get. Her mother played at Wimbledon. Dad was an excellent basketball player. Elise Ray, you know, she just continues to pile up the scores. 9.812. She's in her own little gymnastics world right now. Schweikert's mom and dad now are dealers in Las Vegas. And it's just amazing that there was a meet in Las Vegas that needed a gymnast, and she lived there.
Her coach, Kathy Rice, said right before the competition that Tasha really knows what she needs to do here tonight. She needs to be perfect, and she needs to get a little bit of luck to see if anyone else misses in this competition. She has an opportunity.
And all the gymnasts are banged up in some way. She's had a stress fracture in her left leg that requires ongoing care, ice, therapy, electrostim, whatever. Boy, what an atmosphere in this building.
Complicated vault right here. She'll do a round-off half turn onto the horse. Best that's introduced. It's actually a new vault for Tasha in this competition.
What are these gymnasts going to do to get rid of those one or two extra steps? That's key. And now Jamie Dancer. She roared into St. Louis. And after one rotation, everyone was like, wow, where has that Jamie Dancer been? And then it was two and three and four rotations. And from one day, it was 2 days. And now it's 4 days where Jamie Dancer has looked great.
And Bella has said about this athlete that if she performs here tonight, he will definitely consider for the all-around in Sydney. She's the backbone to this team, he said.
She's going at it exactly the way you should, not holding back, being aggressive on the right side of that very, very scary line. Dismount.
Steve Rybacki with his wife Beth used to coach Vanessa Atler. We've chronicled the story of how Vanessa went to Texas to be with Valerie Liukin and Beth Ruyak here at the Fleet Center has Shannon Miller.
Al, Shannon just walked out of the medical room a moment ago and we heard Steve telling you you have to choose about your health and at this point you have to choose about an Olympic dream. Shannon?
Right now it's not totally a decision whether I'm on the team or not. It's right now, you know, I just landed short. It's a little stiff. Both of them are a little bit stiff, but I think, you know, by tomorrow or the next day, they'll be just fine. Unfortunately, I'm kind of out of the competition tonight, but I'm hoping that, you know, I've showed what I can do. I did that Friday night, and hopefully they'll take that into consideration. And right now, what I'm hoping is that no matter what happens, that, you know, I did the best I could, and, you know, I would have loved to have been able to compete all four events again tonight and try to improve on what I did Friday night, but they'll just kind of have to go with what I did, and we'll see how it all works out.
How tough was this choice, Shannon, to pull out?
It's extremely hard because I didn't know, you know, do I, you know, stop now and just make sure that I'm, you know, totally healthy in a couple days. But if I don't keep going, will they even consider me? So it's, you know, kind of a chance thing, but right now we're just going to go with health and make sure that I'm able to train in 2 days so that if they want me and they want me to do anything for this team, then I'll be ready to do that.
Okay, and Al, she's feeling then like she's out for right now, but not necessarily a final decision. Back to you.
Boy, Beth, it's going to be tough to see how that plays out, but it does seem as though Shannon doesn't want to even deal with the thought right now that this is how it ends. So the Magnificent Seven started at the championships as the Magnificent Five, then quickly it went down, and now it's two. It's Amy Chow and Dominic Dawes left in these Olympic trials. Quickly, Tasha Schweikert, 9-1-3-1 on the vault. Jamie Dancer, solid, 9-6-2-5 on the uneven bars. Is this one of those events where Dawes would look to fit in?
Absolutely, no question about it. Bella Paroli loves her style, mostly on the uneven bars. She says it's unique. There's a ton of routines.
But he said this one is a big routine.
And he likes the element coming up here most. Watch how she flies here. Oh, a little bit close on that, but no problem.
Dominique Dawes looking to return to the Olympics for a third time. Next up, the balance beam, Vanessa Atler and Alyssa Beckerman, now living life on the bubble. Back live at the Fleet Center in Boston, Massachusetts. Dominique Dawes moments ago making a strong bid to return to the Olympic Games for a third time. She scored a 9.625, and here are the standings. Largely, they remain unchanged. It's still Elise Ray with almost a point lead over Kristen Maloney. Then Amy Chow, who's got a 0.4-plus lead over Jamie Dancher. And then it's Morgan White, solidly in fifth. Dominique Dawes has vaulted in front of Vanessa Attler. And then there's Tasha Schweikert, who's about 0.6 behind Attler, whose trials are slowly but surely coming apart. Let's revisit quickly the story of Shannon Miller. She withdraws from the Olympic trials after doing one routine at the U.S. National Championships. In the selection procedures, Tim, what does it say?
It says that you do not have to participate in any of the competitions to be selected for the team. However, yesterday, Bella Caroli was emphatic that if someone is injured, he's not going to take them. But, you know, it's always been just a little bit wishy-washy on this subject. There's a lot of things that are in the selection procedures written down, but there are also a lot of loopholes that are intentionally in there to protect them so they can get the best team they think they've got.
All right, let's see how Alyssa Beckerman takes advantage of what has to be viewed as a big chance here.
Yeah, it's a huge opportunity for her. Mary Lee Tracy said on the first night she fell apart, plain and simple, and she said she got distracted by her fans. She actually turned around and waved to them. She acknowledged her fans when they were calling her name. She said, I got to prevent that tonight.
She's on the balance beam, awaiting the green flag as we move to rotation three. She is good enough to put up a score like a 9.6 or a 9.7. However, in night one of the Olympic trials, she struggled and fell to an 8.8.
Yeah, she's the national champion on this event, and she had a lot of different problems throughout the beam routine on the first day. Big test for her right here.
That was rock solid.
Alyssa has stunning lines, especially on an apparatus like this.
Yeah, she's feeling back at home on this event.
Mary Lee Tracy said only one thing will put her on the team. She needs to compete wide open.
Everyone is on. To the two-time national champion, Kristen Maloney from the Parkettes in Allentown, PA. For a long time, it was felt she didn't get the respect that they felt she should in her gym, but she took care of that out on the floor.
She will get a lot of respect in Sydney for this floor exercise routine. Take a look at that. Not many women performing that skill.
Thank you.
Boston with a bit of a sore ankle. We saw her continue to tumble day after day in practice.
I'll tell you, though, that just looked like, I don't know, she let up on it a little bit. She...
So Krista Maloney gathers herself, but she's in very good shape in the standings. Now, Vanessa Attler about to mount the balance beam in night one of the Olympic trials. What happened was almost a disaster. What it was really scary.
She misses her foot. Is a little crooked with her hands on the skill before it, and yikes.
Now back live.
This is her first major test right here. Long tumbling sequence, ending with a layout. Great.
Don't you think she absolutely has to nail this?
Yeah, but it's amazing, Al. You know, she struggled already tonight on bars, and then she has this mishap on vaulting, and she does this so often on the most stressful event. She goes to beam, and she hits it. It just
doesn't make sense.
Here we go.
Right on.
Yeah, no problem. Oh my gosh.
Wow.
This is not going well at all. Lots more gymnastics to come on this very final night of the U.S. Olympic trials. Vanessa Attler gets a score of 9.325 on that balance beam routine.
I don't know.
Too high.
She does this dismount. It should be a significant deduction. She should lose some bonus. Sorry, but I don't think that's right. Trying to figure out what's going on here. Obviously, scores, they do matter a little bit, but performance matters more.
You got to think that the performance matters to Bella more.
And here's Elise Ray on the floor. 9.55 for Beckerman on beam.
Thank you.
she won with Dominique Dawes 4 years ago at the Olympic trials, would like to do the same with this young lady here.
Now Morgan White on the balance beam.
And this is the big test right here. She gets through this routine cleanly. She's got floor exercise left. And I would say she is on the Olympic team. Trickiest tumbling run right here.
This is crucial.
She'll turn around. Perfect. Mary Lee is saying to Morgan all day long, big picture, Morgan, big picture. She says sometimes she's so critical on herself, the small little mistakes get her off track. Big picture, four sets, hit.
Pressure tonight like they will in Sydney. This bodes well for Morgan White.
And this landing right here, Mary Lee Tracy told me, hey, you know, she's got to go. She's the one, but heck, I want to go too.
Our very animated coach, Mary Lee Tracy, joyous. What do you think Bella was saying here, Tim?
Yeah, he is saying that that is the one. That's the one.
And for Morgan White, wife Debbie, thinking about going to Sydney. We'll be back in Boston after this. Here in Boston moments ago, it was about the numbers for Mary Lee Tracy and her prize pupil, Morgan White. Everything they have to do to impress Bella Caroli, but Bella Caroli will always be impressed by a 9.625 on the beam. Elise Ray moments ago put up a 9.812 on the floor, so she's solid. Bella Caroli ominously wearing black tonight. Some difficult choices to be made. Jamie Dancher getting set to mount the floor. She's fourth after two rotations, and I think if women's gymnastics had a headline, she and Amy Chow would share in it.
This routine, one of the most difficult, one of the most beautiful routines that we'll see, not only here, but even at the Olympic Games.
Crowley told me he got a glimpse of just how strong-minded this young lady was at his camp.
Steve and Beth Rybecki. Beth, of course, a 1980 Olympian, never got to fulfill. Walking in those opening ceremonies, she says that's what she missed out on most.
Beth was telling me today about going through the Olympic trials in 1980. She didn't even remember where they were. I think she blocked them out because during the trials, everyone knew that there was a boycott. It was a very empty feeling, and how enriching it would be if they could go with Jamie Dancher to the Olympics in Sydney.
And it hasn't been easy with this young lady. She has really tested, really challenged them.
And you know, Tim talked about the difficult tumbling. It was absolutely awesome. She has the combination of power and grace. She's got the package. We've talked about that. But look at the look on her face when she dismounts right here. There's confidence in that face. She wants to go to Sydney.
Jamie comes from a hard-working family. Her dad manages a grocery store. Her mom is a waiter. They're here, Joyce and John. She comes from a family of seven. Five of them still live at home, so you know that Joyce and John have had a busy life. And imagine in all of that, all that goes into taking Jamie to the gym and picking Jamie up at the gym and taking Jamie to the gym. And back and forth they went. Back and forth she went with the Rybackis twice, too. But when she came back, talks with them, talks with Bella Caroli, he got in her face a little bit, and suddenly this star came out. Jamie Dancher, 985. Coaches. Now back to Dominique Dawes. Dominique, so far here tonight, has been the fifth best gymnast. Scored okay on the vault. Hit on the unevens, 9.6 plus.
And this is an important one because, remember, we've been talking about Vanessa Adler, how she typically fills the void of vaulting and floor.
In an arena that knows its gymnastics. Elise Ray coming over, and there's Dominique Mociano. She's providing insight on some of the technical things that are happening here at the Olympic trials at NBCOlympics.com. But of course, Dominique Mociano had thought to be right in the middle of the mix at these Olympic trials. But something bad happened to Dominique in training for this event, and so she had to call it quits. She was one of Bella Caroli's chosen ones, the follow-up to Nadia and Mary Lou. A perfect combination of Romanian blood and a Hollywood birth, Dami. Dominique Mociano had it, and Caroli was there at every step, No one was shocked when she was the youngest national champion. It was like a sprint that led to Olympic gold.
I'd like to be remembered like the old Dom, just smiling and having fun. The Dom that they first fell in love with, that smile, that young Dominique. Like how much I had been through and understand that, you know what, it was a hard road, but I gave it my all. Just being a two-time Olympian would have meant a lot to me. I had been through so much these last couple years, just that would have just been great. Like at the end of the rainbow, pot of gold. I was so psyched after nationals to try to get better. At least in my heart, I know that I tried. God, if I could just show them one more time, show everyone what I'm capable of, I still had it in me.
Tuesday, here in Boston, she withdrew from the trials. Her knee now holding a debilitating chip of bone. The Olympic comeback won't happen. Sometimes, you just don't get that second chance. Dominique Mociano will have knee surgery in a few weeks. In January, they'll fix something in her shoulder. She wants to try and be part of the post-Olympic gymnastics tour. J.C. Phelps also pulled out in the midst of trying to return to the Olympics. And now Amy Chow is getting set on the floor. The crowd reacting to the Dominique Dawes score on the floor of 9.275. They liked it a lot more than that. What was her start value?
Well, her start value was only a 9.7. She missed some connections.
Amy has been phenomenal today. 9.725 and 9.537.
Her coach, Mark Young, said sometimes they've been criticized for not going to all the practices, but he said, I've been with her for 19 years, since she was 3 years old.
Can you imagine? Amy Chow is the number one gymnast here tonight. If you took only the scores, and it's only two rotations, but still, that's significant for a gymnast who really hedged like all the other members of the Magnificent Seven until it was almost too late to rededicate themselves to returning to the Olympic Games. And actually, with a 9.5 and change, Amy Chow could pass Kristen Maloney of all people in the standings. Bella continues to take it all in. Right now in Boston, Shannon Miller was expected to be ready to compete on beam, but in her first vaulting attempt tonight, she injured a knee and had to withdraw. Does Bella Caroli find some way to make her one of the two alternates? And is that why he has two alternates for a situation just like this? We'll find out before the night is done. Meanwhile, after our coverage tonight on NBC, join Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel for a live talk. Hear the comments from all interested parties and interviews from Beth Ruyak. Plus, post your own comments in the chat room at NBCOlympics.com. Amy Chow has surprisingly moved into second place in front of an amazing crowd here in Beantown. She has slid into second in front of Kristen Maloney. Jamie Dancer solidly in fourth. Morgan White is where she's been in fifth. Dominique Dawes jumps ahead of Vanessa Attler into sixth. Alyssa Beckerman is back to eighth. Now remember, at the conclusion of this Olympic trials, which for Vanessa Attler is coming up in about a 90-second span, Bella Caroli and three members of the committee are going to pick six names. It doesn't have anything to do with the standings at all, although in many ways it probably will. What has Vanessa Attler done to her status here tonight?
I think one of the big question marks is coming into this competition, we thought the voids that she would fill for this team are vault and floor exercise. But after her performance on vault, I mean, the door's wide open. If you ask me, I think Dominique Dawes could fulfill that role. And I find it interesting that Bella said Dominique Dawes' vault tonight was critical. She hit them tonight.
Has either been climbing Mount Olympus or Heartbreak Hill. We'll know in a short while. It's like she's had the flu, Tim. You know, it started on the unevens, and now it's spread to just about every apparatus.
I was just ready to say, as she's finishing her triple twist, that this is the best, most aggressively performed routine for Vanessa Attler all evening, maybe all weekend. And then she kind of gets funky in the air on that triple full. Golly.
Back to Elise Ray as she wraps her Olympic trials up on the beam.
Bella's really looking to this athlete to carry the weight of this team heading into Sydney. She will, no question, be an all-around athlete there.
Come from?
I was going to say, of all athletes in this competition tonight, she probably had the least amount of pressure on her.
And leading by 1.13 over Amy Chow. That will not destroy her Olympic dream.
You know, maybe she's just pooped. This is the eighth event in a very rough 48-hour emotional period. Vanessa Attler, 9.437 on the floor.
Well, you know, once again, she opened the door. She's capable on vault, on floor, of getting not 4.37, but 9.775. And I just don't know what they're going to do. If they go straight by the numbers, this thing gets a little bit crazy, I got to tell you, because there's no question. This team is weakest on vault. You got to fill that hole.
Well, it's out of Vanessa Attler's hands now. Here is Jeanette Antolin. Jeanette is coached by Don Peters, who's been on the gymnastics scene for a long, long time, and she just had a disaster on the balance beam. What happened there, LP? 7.95.
Yeah, Jeanette basically is out of this competition, out of the running. I mean, there never was any hope. But we have to remember, she came into this Olympic trials, had to complete a verification competition on the Tuesday. This is her third competition.
Stepped out.
Gymnastics scholarship,
where eventually she'll be teammates with Kristen Maloney. So that'll do it for these Olympic trials for Jeanette Antolin. Meanwhile, Elise Ray, who after the Olympics will be a Wolverine at Michigan.
Yeah.
After that fall, she gets an 8.862. She has the top spot locked. No one can pass her. That's how good she's been. To Jamie Dancer, who has reached the moment, she's been so solid, where after this is done, if she gets through it, does a good job of coming close to sticking it, she, I think, can celebrate.
She's been in this position before. She, oh!
Oh, my. Yikes. Oh, geez, this is...
What about the fatigue factor?
You know, I don't really think it has to do with that. I think that it is almost cruel and unusual punishment to ask somebody to finish up on balance beam to fulfill a lifelong dream. It's just, it's too hard. It's... Tracy Talavera, who's on the selection committee, told me before the meet began that she's going to listen to her heart, she's going to look at the numbers, but she's also going to factor in common sense.
Hasn't she been good enough so far to have common sense say those two falls off the beam don't matter?
In my book, she does. She has been.
Tim, you always say you want your gymnasts to fight through it. And that was a big-time fight. And now, just when you thought you could celebrate a trip to the Olympics,
Well, right from the get-go, front somersault.
Yeah, you have to be absolutely square in your shoulders, your hips, or you're off the beam.
Joyce and John.
Unreal.
With everyone around them.
She has been so good. And such a shining example of how tremendous an athlete can grow into, what you can grow into.
Well, Jamie Dancer may be a true test of whether the numbers count or not. Well, here's Morgan White. And Morgan White's story is that she has really finished up this Olympic trials in strong fashion. She's had herself a great night in Boston.
What does it feel like to be an Olympian? Ask Morgan White.
Boy, and there were some bumpy moments.
Good job, Morgan. Good job.
Jamie Dancer takes a big hit on the beam, 8.275. She had seven other good turns here in Boston. Bella Caroli crunching the numbers. Just a few more routines to go, and then it is D-Day at the Fleet Center. Three scores in the 9.6s tonight. She wraps up her Olympic trials with a 9.65 on floor exercise. Right now, you've got to feel she's looking good, but let's turn now to Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel to talk for a minute about the dilemma of Bella Caroli and the selection committee. The men took 31 minutes to decide, and they were only picking two spots. Bella and his group are picking six and two alternates.
That's Kathy Kelly sitting next to Bella. She's the director of the women's program. She does not have a vote on that selection committee. Tracy Talavera, who was an Olympian herself, an Olympic medalist, she's got a vote. There's Tracy in the back. Sherry Knight Hunter, also an athlete representative. But this thing is going to come down to who Bella believes can do the job at the Olympic Games under all of that pressure. And I'm sorry, I just can't imagine that he chooses to go with somebody who has had a disastrous meet today like Vanessa Adler. Now, this young lady right here came out and was much stronger today. The problem with Alyssa Beckerman, she does not plug the biggest hole that Team USA has. That hole comes on vaulting. Morgan White, she is going to go to the Olympic Games. She has averaged 8.951 in her four meets. That's not good enough in Sydney.
But like I said earlier, I think Dominique Dawes might be that one that can fill that hole on the vault. Bella said to me before this competition, vault was critical for her. He wanted to see her be better. Now she's ending on balance beam. If she can have the routine of her life, I don't know how he can deny her.
And when you go with Dominique Dawes, you also get another big return. You got a marquee player right there. This young lady, not one-time Olympian, two-time Olympian, and she's got a gold medal to go with it. You walk out onto the floor in Sydney, Australia. The Russians are looking, the Romanians. Everybody's saying, oh, the Americans, they got a different team. Dominique Dawes, she's back.
So who's out?
Right now, it does not look good for this young lady right there.
Unless Bella Caroli thinks that after the team is chosen and they go to his ranch outside of Houston for 10 days, that he can somehow get her straight. Do you think he believes that?
Well, that's a possibility. There's no question about it. He said to me earlier today, Jimmy, don't forget vaulting. We need a vaulter. And Vanessa Adler, she is a born vaulter. She didn't show it today, though.
We've come down now to the last few routines. Dominique Dawes has a shot to go on the beam. Amy Chow, Krista Maloney, and then that's it. It's decision time.
This matters too, right here, though, because this is incredible pressure. I do not believe start value. I do not believe small little tents matter in this routine. What matters, can she deal with the pressure?
Stick a routine.
And stick a routine. Like that.
Another big test for Dawes right here. She had trouble at Nationals. Solid. This is it, just the dismount. Wow.
I'm a gold medalist. Get out of my way. Bella Caroli standing and clapping.
She's got that gold medal wave down, too.
It was awesome. I mean, it all came down to just staying on the balance beam. She has been in this position before. The pressure, she knows what it's all about, and she looked cool.
Watch this. Elise Gray and Dominique Dawes. Are they going to be teammates? Here's Amanda Stroud. In St. Louis on the uneven bars on the dismount. Her knee came up and broke her nose. And she's also competing here at the trials with a huge bandage around her left knee.
May not be her time, but I'll tell you, this young lady, she has got tremendous athletic ability. Coach told me it's just a great experience being on the floor with all these potential and former Olympic greats.
prior to the Nationals, some people were talking up Amanda Stroud a lot like people were talking up Elise Gray a year ago. That's how quick it can happen. Amanda Stroud's Olympic trials are over. She's going to finish last ahead of only Shannon Miller, but I don't know that that matters. She got through it.
Congratulations. Great year.
Now, Amy Chow on the beam. They still have not announced the score for Dominique Dawes. Dawes got a 9.037. When the crowd hears that, they're going to go nuts.
You know, I said that I don't really think that the start value and all that stuff will matter much with Dawes.
Well, that was a close call. Big
watch
element.
This right here, yeah.
This is world class.
Just think about doing that just in your living room. Make sure you push the coffee table out of the way.
Time dismount coming up. Ends with a triple.
She was great. Dismount. There were some people that were actually saying she should change the dismount to make it easier. I don't think so.
You gotta believe that when those feet hit the ground, that she and he go to Sydney.
Mark Young is her coach. They've been together since she was three. They were together in Atlanta. Right now it looks like they'll be together in Sydney. And wow. What a return to competition for Amy Chow. Now, Rachel Titt is someone that Tim Daggett looked at. She's from San Marcos, California. She's 16. And one of the reasons that, Tim, you looked at her name, even though she's 10th coming into this last rotation, is because she's pretty good on vaulting.
Well, she got a 9.437 today on vault. And, you know, they could make a statement that someone like Rachel Titt or even Amanda Stroud might fit that bill in possibly the alternate position. We just don't know. You know, this young lady, I know Bella Caroli was very impressed with. She's got tremendous lines. She's a natural athlete. He just thought maybe it was 6 months too early.
Just a junior last year, she has really shot up in the seniors. Her goal was to make the Olympic trials. Second time out of bounds there. Those are 2/10 deductions.
And those are somewhat experienced deductions, that one right there.
So now we've seen everybody, all 14 women who came to Boston for these Olympic trials. Amy Chow, 9.687. The judges liked it as much as the crowd did. She got a prolonged standing ovation. And last rotation had moved in front of Kristen Maloney, who now gets set to mount the beam.
No question in my mind that this athlete has been one of the most consistent for the U.S. over the past 3 years. Part of that consistency is her balance beam routine.
And it is remarkable what she has come back from in less than a year. Two major surgeries, one to her leg, one to her shoulder.
She won her second national championship with a stress fracture in her leg that a rod had to be inserted to fix.
Oh.
Boy, this beam is absolutely devilish.
Eating them alive today.
I don't know the last time that I saw Kristen Maloney fall off balance beam.
A little bit, the pressure might be off some of these young ladies. This is not how you want to finish your Olympic trials, though. It's not how you want to make your Olympic team. You want the last one. You want to run into the crowd. You want to hug your coach, and it's so hard to do that when the last thing you did wasn't as good as you can do it.
Is certainly not off Alyssa Beckerman. Alyssa had to take major note when Shannon Miller withdrew and when Vanessa Attler started making mistake after mistake after mistake. I mean, basically, Vanessa went 0 for 4 here tonight.
Yes, but the big problem, Al, is she has not scored above 8.85 on vaulting in any of the four competitions. She scored an 8.556 here tonight.
And she has no more opportunities to impress with the vault.
But she can impress here.
Stepped out.
Stepped out, but no flag.
Flag can go up.
Thank you.
Okay, that's it. Alyssa Beckerman concludes the competition at the 2000 Olympic Trials. A hopeful hug from her coach, Mary Lee Tracy. And now Bella Caroli, Tracy Talavera, Shari Knight-Hunter, and Marilyn Cross will go into a back room here at the Fleet Center. When they come out, after what is only expected to be a few minutes, because they've been conversing all night, hearts will be broken and dreams will be fulfilled.
Well, I'll tell you what I think is going to happen. Tracy said to me, you know, we get to decide, but somebody always decides. The judges used to do it exclusively. Now we get to decide along with that man right there. But I have to tell you, the major question mark right now, I don't see this team coming together with five strong vaulters. Six people make an Olympic team on each event. Five athletes compete and four scores count. Ray, she's a lock. Amy Chow, if she's not, I think they're all crazy. Krista Maloney, she's done too much to not be on this team. I think Jamie Dancher's one fall that should not erase her Olympic dream. Morgan White, she's going. It comes down to Dawes and Beckerman, and I think they take Dawes, and Beckerman's going to be your alternate.
Who's the other alternate, as long as you're picking?
Now you're getting pushy, Al.
All right. Elfie, you want to rattle off a quick six?
Right there, that's it.
It's too tough to do.
He's okay.
In they go. That's Bob Colarossi, the CEO of USA Gymnastics. So it will be. Six names, two alternates that will be paraded onto the floor in minutes in Boston. Back live in Boston for 4 minutes and 35 seconds. Bella Caroli and his selection committee have been behind that closed door. Moments ago, they received the official final computer standings, and they're going to chew over that for a little bit. Remind you that when this was done in the men's Olympic trials, it took over 31 minutes. The women have been taken to a waiting area where they're waiting with their coaches. There is Shannon Miller, who after her first vault was forced to withdraw because of knee pain. She's hoping for some sort of miracle to keep her third Olympic dream alive. Back with Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel, Al Trauer here in Boston. I mean, wild stuff the way it unfolded. Tim, you got a chance to make your team picks. Elfie, what about you?
Well, I agree with Tim. The top six, in my mind, Ray, Chow, Maloney, White, Dancher, and Dawes. I would like to see Dominique Dawes on the team. I think she's proven it to Bella Caroli. She's hit her routine. The alternate, who knows, it could go to Beckerman or even Atler.
Now, this would be no surprise to anyone that the ego of Bella Caroli factors in here at some point. We have all said amongst ourselves that if Vanessa Atler had been handed over to Billy Caroli at some point, he would have been the one to fix her, to mold her. Now, he's going to have this team after here. They're going to fly out, be at his ranch for 10 days starting Wednesday. Then they'll be there for a week and a half and begin to move west toward the Olympics. Is it a rational thought for him that he could take this Vanessa Atler and somehow get it straight?
It's a possibility. There's no question about it. It's a possibility. He recognizes her talent. He said to me yesterday that she might be the most talented athlete he's ever seen. Now, I said that years ago, and I still believe it, but you have to also look a little bit at performance. And I'm sorry, she's a wonderful athlete, but she did not perform wonderfully, especially here today. By my book, she went 0-for-4. Almost did one of the best beam routines of her life, but then right at the end, once again, and then on floor exercise, finally the Vanessa Atler that we could see. Last tumbling pass gets a little funky, bends her knees in the air, doesn't finish the triple fold. And the biggest problem is it wasn't a physical mistake. That's not what happened. What happened was she was finishing her routine too early in her head. She thought it was all over, and she got to finish her exercises.
Now, Elfie, I know this would never happen to you, but let's say you were having Vanessa's problems. Could you go someplace for 10 days with a guru like him and get straightened out?
Well, I'm sure if anyone can do it, it's Bella Caroli, but we have to realize that this was all about pressure and competition. She didn't prove herself in the heat of the moment. And how do you take a chance with an athlete like Vanessa Atler at the Olympic Games? Do you just expect her to do it then? She hasn't done it.
All right, let's explain one thing. 6-5-4. What exactly does that mean, Tim?
Six members are the Olympic team. The alternates are not recognized by the IOC as Olympians. So there are six Olympic team members. Five athletes go up on each event. From those five athletes, the USA needs four scores on each apparatus. So if you take a look at the people who look to be locked, that means that Morgan White, she's going to be going. And that means that there's only five vaulters, and you can't use Morgan White. You just don't want to go into the Olympic Games with a gymnast that has not scored a 9-0 average on an event over four meets.
Okay, so what does that mean then? You have to fill that hole with somebody else. Does someone like a Shannon Miller stand a shot here of getting one of those two alternate spots? Because obviously in that conversation we had with her and her coach Steve Nuno, she still harbors some belief that that's possible.
Well, it's possible. I mean, anything's possible. I go back to what Bella Caroli said. At this point, I'm sorry to say this in a lot of ways, but if they choose Shannon Miller, they are choosing her because of the leadership that she will bring to this team and the status that she helps elevate the Americans to. It's not because of her performance, because she hasn't proved that.
But if Bella sticks to her word, his word, then he will not take an injured athlete.
The plan was 5 minutes in that room. We're coming up on 9 minutes with Bella Caroli. Again, Tracy Talavera, the former USA gymnast, Shari Knight Hunter, and Marilyn Cross, all going at it right now. Now, we're scheduled to sign off here on NBC after the team is announced, and right after at NBCOlympics.com, you can chat live with Elfie Schlegel and Tim Daggett. Beth Ruyak will be working the floor and the locker rooms backstage, and you'll be able to read all those interviews, plus post your own opinions about what you've seen and what about the team that was selected. That's all at NBCOlympics.com on the World Wide Web. Still no movement. The door remains closed. What do you think is the real sticking point here, Tim? Is it the fifth and sixth spots, or is it the alternates?
No, I do not think that it's going to be the alternates. They are trying to come up with what will produce the best potential team score. And I guarantee you, the same philosophical discussion that we're having out here on the floor is occurring in that back room. They are saying that, look at this young lady, Vanessa Adler. Yes, she didn't prove it today. She can get a 9-6 for us on vaulting. Our next lowest vault score is somewhere around a 9.2. That one event alone gives us 0.4. Do we throw that away? It's a tough call.
Imagine these coaches now. There's Steve Rybacki in the middle there with Mary Lee Tracy. I mean, Mary Lee at one point came to the national championships with Dominique Moschiana, Morgan White, Alyssa Beckerman, feeling really good. Maybe even about three of her athletes. Then Dominique Moschiana gets hurt and pulls out. Morgan White struggles a little bit. Alyssa Beckerman struggles a little bit. She went from three to none, and now maybe two. Her emotions are all over the place. Steve Penny from USA Gymnastics over there talking to Mark Young, Amy Chow's coach. Kelly Hill, she's smiling. It can't be bad news. Bill and Donna Strauss and Jack Carter from the Parkettes, they're Kristen Maloney's coaches. Now, we think that the announcement is forthcoming. Coming up on 11 minutes, the Fleet Center has gone quiet. Let's see.
Yes.
The door has not opened. Last night, for half an hour, this joint was jumping in anticipation of the announcement of the men's team. Now here come the women. Well, this is the entire team. Only those selected were supposed to go out onto the floor. So everybody's coming out. They look a little confused. Is this when they get the good and bad news? Let's find out.
Al, I don't know if you're hearing me, but Steve Penny just talked to the coaches and said that the coaches would be giving the team the news as to whether the athletes made the team or not. We were under the impression they'd be back in the locker room. A few of them have just walked out here, so there seems to be a little bit of confusion as to exactly what's going on. I did just talk a few moments ago to Vanessa Adler's coach, and I asked if Vanessa would be satisfied with being an alternate on this team. Valeri Lukin said that they had talked about it, and she does not want to do that if that's the choice. So we'll hear her in a few moments. I'm going to throw it back to you, Al, because looks like they're getting together, but the committee has not come out of the room yet.
Oh, here comes Bob Colarossi, the CEO of USA Gymnastics. Man, are the fortunes going to change here?
Mm-hmm.
Jamie Chow, Jamie Dancer, Dominic Dawes, Kristen Maloney, Elise Ray, and Morgan White. The alternate is Alyssa Beckerman.
Came through. Morgan White. I'm a little surprised we only heard one alternate's name. We were told there were going to be two.
Bella told me that they would like to name two. 2 minutes before the meet began, and there is the alternate, Alyssa Beckerman, right there.
She is going to Sydney. Shannon Miller may be dealing with that thought that she tried to postpone. Dominique Dawes pulled it off. Third Olympics for her. It's about to be party time at the Fleet Center. We'll be back on NBC in a moment.
Okay.